Awesome. Yeah. So hope you guys can see my screen. Awesome. So yeah. Hey folks, I'm Raksha. I'm a software developer at Microsoft, and I graduated with a BTech in electrical and electronics engineering, NIT Trichy, India. And so a little about me. I am a hackathon enthusiast. I love to do a lot of art and crafts in my free time, and I'm crazy about anything that's tech. So any new tech coming up, I would probably be one of the most crazy people to try it out. So yeah, let's dive in. So today's agenda would be, what's machine learning? Why do we need machine learning in the first place? Then a broad classification of machine learning, what are the different kinds that we encounter? And then, a general flow chart or a walkthrough of how, what are the basic steps that's involved in a machine learning project. And then we have a practical exercise, I think, which would be fun for all of you to try out on classification and regression. So what is machine learning? So I want this to be a very interactive one. So people, please, unmute or, put it in the chat about what you guys know about machine learning. Related to AI, yeah. So AI is basically a broader subset, and machine learning is a smaller part of AI, if I might add that. So yeah, definitely it's related to AI. Anyone else with any ideas about what machine learning is? Alrighty then, so we will move on. And yeah, takes past information and improves itself. Yeah, that's a very nice way to put it. Yeah. So it learns from the data that we give, and it learns and figures out what to do in each of the scenarios. So in a very broad way, yeah, that's machine learning. Yeah. So we have heard this fun quip that our parents usually thrust upon us. If all your friends jumped off a bridge, would you jump too? So if we put, for argument's sake, pass this statement into a machine learning model, it would probably say yes, because that's pretty much what all of my friends are doing. So based on the data, that's what I'm supposed to do. So moving on. Let's get to the serious part. Introduction to ML. So what is machine learning? Machine learning, as someone rightfully pointed out, probably it's related to AI. So it is a subset of artificial intelligence. And what is artificial intelligence? Artificial intelligence is basically any intelligence that is imparted into a machine for it to take its own decisions, for the ability of the machine itself to solve the problems. So what it does, it generates the algorithms and analyzes the data that's provided to them and performs various tasks without any human intervention. So yeah. So this is the famous quip again. Don't tell the computer how to do things. Tell them what to do and let them surprise you with the results. So in machine learning, it's essentially you giving the problem statement and, okay, see, this is what we need to solve, and let the machine figure out how to get there. So, for example, let's say we have a history of house prices in Boston based on a number of parameters. Based on this data, the machine itself will be able to extrapolate and let you know what's the predictable price at that a city with different parameters that's involved. So moving on to types of machine learning. So can anyone over here who have heard about machine learning tell me what any of this is? If any of these words sound completely random and strange to you, it's completely okay. But if any of you guys have heard of what this is, do this.
How about now? Is it better? Oh, okay, awesome. Yeah, sorry about that. Yeah, so it is broadly classified into how much of human intervention is there and what kind of human intervention, to be precise. So supervised learning is the type of machine learning in which the machines are trained using well-labeled data. So, okay, what is a label? So most of you guys have heard. So if you need to classify anything, or if you need to categorize anything, you usually have a label, right? Like, okay, these are all the files that I have. These are all the folders that I have. Okay, I'm gonna sort them based on, whatever parameter that I choose. So let's say it's alphabetical. So whatever classification that you use, you will be putting them under a bracket or a label. So these machine algorithms are trained on well-labeled data. And based on this well-labeled data, the machines can predict the output. So we have two broad broad algorithms that we put under supervised, which is, classification and regression. We'll try out a fun exercise towards the end on each of these so that you will get a better hang of how this works. Unsupervised learning is referred to the use of artificial intelligence algorithms to identify the patterns in the data sets. And these data sets are neither like classified nor labeled. So if, let's say, you are given a bunch of things and you are classifying them based on the proximity to each other, so there is no labeling or there's no classification that's done in the training data per se. So types of these would be clustering and associative rules. So for a beginner, this might not make much sense. So let's just skip over this for a bit. Moving on to reinforced learning. So reinforced learning is the training of machine learning models to make a sequence of decisions. So, but before we go about all of these, so I hope you guys have understood what a label is. In machine learning, you have two basic terminologies that we use. We have something called a feature, and we have something called a label. Feature is basically any of the input parameters that you put in. So let's say it's for comparing Boston house prices. Let's say it's the quality of the sand, or it's like the cost of the bricks. What are parameters that we choose? And label is the output. So let's say the price is, whether we are determining the price or whether we are determining, whether it's going to be a cat or a dog. Those things are all the labels. So, reinforcement learning is basically any kind of, real-time learning that a system does. So as I think one of you pointed out in the chat, it's like it takes its past information and improves itself in real time. It's like a computer learning how to play a video game. So that's a very simple way of understanding how reinforced learning works. Moving to the next slide. So we have these broad four steps that we use in machine learning. So first, and the most important step, is importing and cleaning data. So for any type of machine learning function or machine learning project that you are going to use, data is of extreme importance. And to know that you have the right kind of data, first you need to get data from proper sources. So for you guys, I think when we start out, we usually start out with, you know, Kaggle data sets or any data sets that is available online, or, you know, anything that's a credible source of data, you know. And we then clean it. So most of this information would probably be useful to us, but there may be some null values. There may be some, you know, haphazard values that we don't really need in our data, which, you know, may cause the model to malfunction in the future. It may completely derail our project. And frankly speaking, there have been a lot of projects that have gone completely down the drain because they haven't cleaned their data properly, or, you know, they haven't done their research in knowing which data is meaningful and which is not. The next step is splitting up the data. So over here, splitting up of data essentially means you will need a set of data for training the model, and you will need a set of data to test whether that model makes sense or not. You know, to test how much the machine has learned from the model, I mean, from the data that's provided to it. So that's where we split the existing data, because, you know, we wouldn't be going and looking for a new set of data for it to get in. So we are basically importing the data. We are going to clean the data. We're going to figure out which one is important, which one is not. We're going to do a bunch of functions on it, and then we're going to split it up. So we are going to have a majority chunk in which we are going to use it to train, so that most, you know, more the data, the better, in very layman terms. So we are then going to use the testing data to check the accuracy of the model. The third step is creating a model or an algorithm. So mostly, you know, Python has a lot of models and algorithms that's out there for you to test, and you can just either pick one from them, or if you're in, you know, if you want to try something out, you can create your own model, you know, fine tune the parameters, and you can try creating your own model. And the last step is basically testing, training the model, and then testing it out. So yeah. And if we find the output is not satisfactory, we're going to do it all over again. So we're going to check which step it's not sitting right with us, and we're going to do it all over again. So till the time we get, you know, satisfactory results. So how many fans of Python in the house? So if you guys have worked with Python before, please put it in the chat. Or if you guys are wanting to learn more about Python, do let us know as well. Oh, Asim, Tara loves Python. Nice. Yeah. Any other fans of Python over here? Oh, they've also lives. Yeah. Yeah. So yeah, if people have experienced the power of Python, you wouldn't move back from that. So Python is a pretty awesome language when it comes to machine learning. You know, it has a very rich library ecosystem. You have plenty of functions you can pick from. If you name anything, you would have a function in Python to do that for you. Secondly, it's very, very close to English language. So it's both very easy to read, and it has a very low entry barrier for you to, you know, understand what's actually going behind the scenes. It's also platform agnostic, which means that you can run it in cloud, you can run it in your local system, you can run it anywhere, and it should work. And it's a very flexible language, and it is backed by a huge community, and people keep making a lot of changes, and they keep contributing in ways which, frankly, it really amuses the heck out of me. So it's an awesome starting point in case you guys have just begun coding, or if you are thinking about beginning coding, or if you want to do some research onto ML, Python is the best starting point there is. So here are a few libraries for us. So we have NumPy, which is used for scientific computing. We have Pandas, which will help us a lot with data analysis. You have Escalon, which itself is like a mega library with a lot of ML algorithms. Then you have TensorFlow, wherein you have all, if you want to go into deep learning and neural networks, you can explore TensorFlow as well. There are other, awesome ones like, PyTorch, but these are my favorite libraries. So do let me know if you have other favorite libraries that you have tried out and, found super useful. So do let us know as well. So yeah, these are a few resources for the hackathon. I'll just share the slide deck as well, so that you guys can check it out. And if you guys want to use these, please feel free to do that. And I think these are awesome starting points in case you're just starting out with ML. So yeah. Okay, let's get to the fun part of the session. So we are going to do two exercises now. So we are going to do a classification exercise, and then we're going to do a regression exercise. So classification exercise is basically, let me just share the link with you guys in the chat. Yeah, so please go ahead and just click on the link. And you should see something. I don't have it because I'm the author of this notebook, but you should have something like, copy the notebook over here, somewhere over here. So please copy the notebook and we can get started. Do give me a thumbs up if you guys are ready to delve deep. I'm just gonna wait for a couple of minutes so that people can all copy the, workshop onto that. Yeah. Awesome. We have a couple of people who have copied it in. Yeah, more people coming through. Yeah. Cool, then let's start. And folks who are joining us, I think they can pick it up from here. So Iris is actually a family of flowers. So it has three different subspecies in it, which is, Iris setosa, versicolor, and virginica. So what we're gonna do here is that given any one flower, we are gonna classify them as either setosa, virginica, or versicolor. So what we're going to do this is that we are going to import a data set. Lucky for us, SKLearn has a data set that has a complete one a set of 150 samples, and it has three labels, which is basically species of iris, the setosa, virginica, and versicolor. And it has four features, basically sepal length, sepal width, petal length, and petal width in centimeters. So what the problem statement that we are given right now is that given a combination of sepal length, sepal width, petal length, and petal width, we are supposed to classify whether it comes into setosa, versicolor, or virginica. So let's get started. So we are going to do a simple import over here from sklearn import data sets. Folks, feel free to, do it along with me if you guys have copied the notebook, so that, you get a hands-on on how this is done. Iris equals data sets dot load. So what we're doing here is we are importing this data sets, and then we are setting a variable iris to the iris data set specifically. So load iris is essentially a function that is going to return the iris data set, and we're just going to put this into iris. I think it's taking a bit of time because it's just connecting to the GPU. Now it should be running. Yeah, it's done. So in the, we have data and we have target in iris. So iris data is basically the features and the target is basically the labels. So based on the X parameters, we are going to determine the Y target or Y label. So we are just going to have iris.data and then y equals iris.target. So as we mentioned before, you know, we have to split this data set into test and train. So what we're going to do is that we're going to separate our test test and train data with the help of test train train test split. And so what we can do over here is we are first going to import this. Import this particular function, train test split. This is a pretty cool function. So what we're going to do after that is we're going to have x train, x test, y train, and y test that's returned out of this. So we are going to call this function train test split. And we're going to pass our x and y into this. So x and y. And we are going to say that, hey, I want this in the ratio of 50%. But over here, 50% might be an overkill. So we're going to just go with 0.8. You know, it's an 80-20 rule. I had to, you know, go back and try a bit of experimentation. So I put it as 0.5. You can go ahead and put it as 0.8 so that, you know, we'll have a more successful training of model. So a 0.8 test size, which would essentially mean that, you know, 80% of this data set that you have is going to be the training data and 20% would be the test data. So we can, you know, bring in any classification algorithm. So for now, we are going to import this algorithm called decision tree classifier. So if you guys are interested in learning what this is and how it works, I think I'll share you the documentation as well. Or a quick, you know, Google search would also do. It is a very, very interesting and very fun function that you can learn about. So we are going to import this decision tree classifier onto classifier. And if you recall, the next step of our process is that we are going to train the model. So we are going to train and we are going to check for the output. So what are we going to do? We're going to do classifier dot fit of x train, y train, and we are going to run this. Okay, now that that's done, so we are going to do this predictions. So we are going to use our x test to test out how close the values are to our y test. So you're going to run it through our classifier. Do let me know if I'm going too fast or if you're not able to. Yeah, what does this fit function do? So it essentially fits our training data. So you have a list of features and you have a set of labels, right? So we're going to use this this set to train our model. So classifier.fit essentially just trains the model to say that, oh, hey, you know, this is the function. And you should be able to learn the correlation between X train and Y train with this data set. So we are going to use this classifier.predict, and we are going to run this. So let's just see. Yeah, so we have the predictions over here, but we also have the actual values, which is the Y test. So what we're going to do in order to test the accuracy, you are going to compare your Y test with your predictions. So lucky for us, we have sklearn to save the day again. So we are going to fire up this function, accuracy score, which is going to exactly, sorry, yeah. It's going to compare both our, Y test and our predictions. And it's going to give us the numbers. So let's see how good our model has trained itself. Oh, 95. So I got a 95% accuracy. So folks, do let me know how much you guys got. I mean, it's not a competition or anything, but it'd be fun to check out how each of our... So I had got 95. People would get 60. People could get 98 or anything that's out there, because this train test split completely splits the data in a very random fashion. So the data that it took for test and train would be different for different people. So it is going to be, different for different people. So do let me know if you guys followed till here. Cool then. So that's not the only classifier that's out there. So you have k-nearest neighbors classifier as well. There are a lot of classifying algorithms that are there. You can just go to sklearn and then see the sheer, vast choices that you have. So whichever suits your data set the best, you can pick it. So we never know, maybe this is better for us. So let's just go back and see if there is any difference when we train it with this. So I'm going to do import neighbors. And I'm going to import. So I can run all of these over again so that it would fit this again into this new. So yeah, over here you can see that the there is a increase in accuracy. So it is 96% over here. So different algorithms might be suitable for different data sets that you're picking, or depending on the problem set, some algorithms would work better than others. So it's completely, your choice which algorithm you pick for this thing. Yeah. So do let me know if you guys have any questions in iris classification, so we can move on to the next one. Let me just share this link as well. Do let me know if you're able to open it and copy it, then we can move ahead with this one as well. Ege is able to copy. Okay, awesome. So yeah, let's move to this. So what we're gonna do now is regression. Yeah. Sure thing. Yeah. I'll just wrap this up in 5 minutes. I think most of it is what we've learned already. So we are gonna do, you know, import the data set, and let's try it over here. We're going to load the Boston data set over here. Okay, so yeah. Apparently, this data set has been removed. Okay, my bad. So yeah, you get the point, right? So we can train it with any data set, and then we are gonna assign it, you know, data and target, and then we are gonna run train to split. And then over here, so one interesting thing about this is that there you had classification. Over here, it's regression. So what regression is basically, we are trying to fit our values and our features into a function, and we are trying to get the labels out of it. So over here, it's a question of, you know, assigning, getting a unique combination of the parameters such a way that we fit it into a function, and the labels, it is an output of this function. So we have, in case of linear regression, we are just basically trying to fit it into a straight line. So let's say you have 5 or 6 parameters. This essentially linear regressor would be trying to fit our training data set into this straight line, into this linear equation in 4 variables or 5 variables. So we are going to try that, and the regressor is going to learn what the equation is and try to fit it and predict it with XTEST. So yeah, you guys can try it out in your own time. I don't want to hold up more. Moving on. So yeah, do let me know if you guys have any questions or if you face any difficulties with this. Yeah. So these are all other resources that are pretty amazing for machine learning. Do let me know if you have any questions, and if you want to discuss more about these. I'm available in Discord, so you guys can let me know if you have any questions about these. Yeah. So thank you everyone for attending today's session. I hope it was useful. Do let me know if you have any ML related doubts. You can reach me on Discord. Yeah. Thank you.